Hello, children of God. My name is Yemi. I trust you are doing well. Thank you so much for joining me again today and for always coming back to this channel. Thank you for your prayers, your love, your support, your words of encouragement. They mean a lot to me, and I'm so grateful for each one of you. Thank you. God bless you. If this is your first time here, you're welcome. Welcome to the family of God. Welcome to this beautiful community. The Lord is doing amazing things in our midst. He's doing wonders, and He has led you here for a reason. And I know that you will be a partaker of what God is doing in our midst. So welcome. God bless you abundantly in Jesus' name. Amen. The Lord gave me a special word for someone today. A special word for someone. Before we jump in, let us pray. Thank you, Father, for this new opportunity, another opportunity to hear your word, another opportunity to hear you speak to our situation. Thank you for what you're doing. Thank you for what you've done. Thank you for what you will still do in our midst. We are so grateful for your wonders, for your miracles, for your healing and deliverance and provision, direction and guidance. Thank you for your angels' charge over us. Thank you for your Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Father, we ask for mercy. Forgive us all our sins and unrighteousness. Wash away every sin in our lives and prepare our heart to receive from you today. Prepare our heart to receive your word. Let it be our guide. Let it be our strength and source of encouragement. In Jesus' name, Lord, use me as your mouthpiece to deliver your word to your children, and let the word I speak today be guided by your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. A few days ago, I shared a word from the Lord for someone who God said he has chosen to be the curse breaker in their family. Someone being the first in their family to achieve a milestone that no one in that family has ever achieved, and them being one to open the way for others in the family to follow. Today, for someone, God gave me an additional layer to that word, and it is very specific. I heard the Lord saying to someone, "You will be the first in your family to release others from poverty, and not just poverty, but the spirit of poverty that has been dealing with your family for generations." I feel like repeating that. The Lord said, "You will be the first in your family to release others from poverty, and not just poverty, but the spirit of poverty that has been dealing with your family for generations." The Lord says it is not something that is just happening. The spirit of poverty did not just start dealing with your family, but the spirit has been dealing with your entire family for a very long time. The Lord says you are currently the only one who has achieved a particular milestone that no one else in your family has achieved. This achievement is the first sign God is giving to you to show you that you've been chosen for this purpose. I also see you closing a particular door in the spirit, a door that was opened long before you were born. This is one of the doors the enemy has been using to have access to your family and afflict your family. The Lord says, as you continue to pray and stand in gap for your family, the yokes will be completely broken off. And I hear the Lord calling you the repairer of broken walls, the one who restores the right way. And you started with yourself by making significant changes in your own life. Praise God. Isaiah 58:12 says, "You will rebuild the ancient ruins You will raise up the age-old foundations, and you will be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of the streets in which to dwell. Another Bible version calls it a repairer of homes, which means you are restoring and rebuilding what was once broken and lost in your family. I felt like the Lord wanted me to speak a little bit about the spirit of poverty, because He's delivering you not just from poverty, but from the spirit of poverty. This word reveals and also confirms that there's a spirit behind poverty. The spirit of poverty is a spiritual and mental stronghold that keeps people in financial bondage. And this is why some people are poor, not because they are lazy or not working hard, but because there's a spiritual force working against them. This is why some people work so hard, have multiple jobs, but at the end of the month or at the end of the year, they cannot account for what they use the money for. I mean, the money they earn from their several jobs, they cannot account for it. This is why you see some people work hard and save up for something, but just when the savings have reached a significant amount, something negative and unexpected happens and sweeps all the money away. This spirit is behind procrastination as well, behind laziness and a lack of motivation to improve one's financial situation. Praise God. The spirit also instills a negative attitude towards wealth, often making people believe that wealth is evil or that being wealthy is wrong, which prevents them from pursuing financial growth. The spirit influences people to make poor financial decisions, leading to mismanagement of resources and continual financial problems. This is the spirit behind it. It also manifests as a generational curse, where patterns of poverty and financial struggle seem to pass from one generation to another. But you and your family are being released from the grip of this evil force. You are being liberated. This very month, you will achieve another milestone, says the Lord. You've achieved one already, but the Lord is saying you will achieve another milestone. And this will serve as another confirmation for you of what God is doing in your life and what He wants to use you to accomplish in your family. Poverty and the spirit of poverty are being broken off from your family, and a generational blessing is being released to you and your family in the name of Jesus. As the Lord has said, others in your family will follow the path you have set. They will follow the path because you've opened the door for them. You will not be the only one, says the Lord. God is using you to open doors for your family, and you will see them stepping into new levels of financial freedom and blessing. They will rise above limitations that have held them back. They will break free from the cycles of lack and hardship, says the Lord. Your breakthrough is a signal that God's favor is upon your family now, and this transformation will be evident for generations to come. Praise God. This is a new season for you, and this season will bring an outpouring of divine opportunities and resources. As you stand in the gap and intercede for your family, God will honor your prayers and faithfulness. You will witness a shift in your family's financial situation, and there will be testimonies of God's goodness and provision in your family. The yokes of the past are being destroyed, says the Lord, and a new legacy, I heard that term, that word, legacy, a new legacy of abundance is being established. Your family will experience the fullness of God's promises. They will live in prosperity and fulfill their God-given destiny. Praise God. I want to encourage you to seek the Lord diligently in this season. Please stay close to God through prayer, through worship, and the study of His Word. And as you do this, He will draw you close to Himself. He will continue to guide and direct your step, and He will open more doors of blessings and breakthrough for you. Praise God. Heavenly Father, thank you. Thank you for your word today. In the name of Jesus, I break the grip of the spirit of poverty over our lives and family. I command every chain and shackle of financial bondage to be destroyed now in Jesus' name. Lord, I command and decree divine intervention in our financial situation. I resist every spirit of lack, delay, and misfortune. I command restoration of everything that has been stolen from us over the years in the name of Jesus. Father, I speak abundance and breakthrough into our lives. I command every lie and stronghold of the enemy that has kept us in financial bondage to be shattered in the name of Jesus. I decree freedom and prosperity over our lives and families right now in the name of Jesus. Father, I command restoration of lost opportunity, stolen blessing, and withheld resources. Let them be restored to us right now in the name of Jesus. Father, release your heavenly resources upon us and bring forth divine connection that will lead us to financial freedom in the name of Jesus. Let your favor and blessings overflow in our lives in the name of Jesus. Father, let your mighty hand of deliverance rest upon us, rest upon our family. Every member of our families will be partaker of this in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. We receive your word. We believe your word, and we trust that your word will come to pass in our lives. We will see the fulfillment of this word, and we will testify to your goodness in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. I love you, and I'm praying for you. God bless you.